this ride.
Check, check, check. Welcome to the Ghostwriter Reviews podcast.
At the end of last month, two nursing home residents in Los Angeles who had just been discharged from the hospital began showing coronavirus symptoms. So their nursing home, Briar Oak on Sunset, isolated those two residents and tested them. And when their tests came back positive, Briar Oak decided that they were going to test all the staff in their facility who had been in contact with those two residents, even though none of the staff were showing symptoms. Even though none of the staff were showing symptoms, 15 of those staff tests came back positive. According to Briar Oak's director of clinical operations, quote, with that number of positives, now you have to be concerned about the possible exposure of everybody. Now, the problem, of course, is that Briar Oak couldn't test everybody, despite being the place where the most Americans are dying from coronavirus. Nursing homes have largely been on their own as individual facilities in terms of trying to get a hold of tests for their residents and their staff. So pretty much no one at any facility anywhere could test everybody. But some nursing home leaders in L.A. were trying. And it turns out there was a larger long-term care facility, the Los Angeles.
Jonathan Coelho was 32 years old, a cancer survivor, but in good health when his wife says he began showing early symptoms of coronavirus about a month ago. He underwent a series of treatments, was intubated. Doctors told his wife, Katie, they expected him to survive. He didn't. Katie was called to the hospital in the middle of the night the day before yesterday. Her husband had suffered cardiac arrest, and she later learned that Jonathan had left her a note in his phone about his devotion to her and their two children, one of whom has a serious medical condition. Katie Coelho joins me now. Katie, I'm so sorry for your loss, and I thank you for being with us. How are you holding up? How are you holding up?
It comes in waves. It's very surreal, I keep thinking in my head. There's going to be a time where I've been without my husband longer than I've been.
We'll be right back.
many people actually have to work every single day to win their daily bread.
COVID-19 is overwhelming the world's wealthiest countries. So how will the poorest cope? With over 2 million confirmed COVID-19 cases and counting, the global public health messages are to stay home, practice good hygiene, and go to a health professional if you think you have symptoms. But how do you wash your hands with no clean water? Or social distance when there's 12 people in a room? And where will you get the money to visit a hospital if you fall ill? From Bangladesh to Venezuela, we take a look at how countries are dealing with the virus and how they'll cope with an expected rising number of cases. The United Nations says around 10% of the world's population live in extreme poverty. They're on less than $2 a day. Most people living below the poverty line belong to two regions, Southern Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa. And high poverty rates are often found in fragile and conflict-affected countries.
So I think one of the key issues that we need to think about when we're considering the impact of the coronavirus pandemic on countries which have lower GDPs, or which are poorer countries, as it were, is that there is immense diversity. And
Well, after he tested positive for the coronavirus, which was a scary moment, and we sent our sympathy at the time, CNN's Chris Cuomo started broadcasting his show from his basement. And from his basement, he delivered firm orders to all Americans, stay home, no matter what.
All right, so while most Americans are staying inside, or should be, right, if they're not out protesting like fools, they're not happy about being told to stay home. Staying home saves lives.
And the rest of us should be staying at home for our mothers and the people that we love. And to keep us farther apart will ultimately bring us closer together in this cause. No matter where the virus goes, the way to stop it will always be the same. Our collective conscientious actions. Staying home.
Hey, proles, scamper back to your hovels. Go inside. Do you hear me? At that exact moment, while Chris Cuomo was demanding that America go inside and get back to their own homes, he wasn't taking the same advice. It turns out that at that moment, he was breaking quarantine himself, despite, as we said, being positive for the coronavirus. One day, Cuomo was spotted by a passing bicyclist who got into a tiff with him. Cuomo attacked the man.
Remember, I'm pulling for you. We're all in this together.